Hi everyone, Mike here, and today I'm going to talk to you about how I start the day with my morning coffee macro. I have a post on my site about how I clear to neutral at the end of every workday. You can read that post here. With that work already done, I can start my day with a quick review of my tasks, calendar, and notes. Add a cup of coffee, and it's hard not to have a good morning. Of course, I wanted to automate setting up my computer to make this initial review, so I made a Keyboard Maestro macro. It opens OmniFocus and puts it on the left half of my screen, Fantastical in the top right quarter, and Drafts in the bottom right quarter. This window setup gives me a nice quick glance over all the relevant information to start my day. However, I don't want to trigger this macro manually. I want this macro to run when I first sit down at my computer in the morning. After all, the coffee hasn't kicked in yet. Keyboard Maestro has a built-in trigger to run a macro whenever a computer wakes from sleep. But this is every time the computer wakes up. I want my macro to run only the first time the computer wakes each day. Some quick Googling found this post on the Keyboard Maestro forums where someone else had a similar first wake of the day request, and the developer of Keyboard Maestro shared a simple little addition to the macro which makes this work. So let me show you how you can make a macro run once during your first wake of the day and then not again until tomorrow. First, just build the macro you want. I want it to hide all applications, then open and move the windows for OmniFocus, Fantastical, and Drafts. I like using groups and renaming them in Keyboard Maestro to make my macros easier to understand. So I built a sequence for each app, then grouped the actions. Each one activates the app in question, moves and resizes the window for the app, then navigates to the part of the app I want to see first thing in the morning. However you decide to build your macro, I think it's a good idea to build and test it first to make sure that it works the way you want it to before you add the following logic. Set your macro trigger to @systemWake. Add an if-then-else action up top. Add a variable condition. I named this variable lastWakeDay. Then switch this option from contains to is exclamation point equals and type capital DAY open and close parentheses in the field. There are no spaces in this field. Then move the actions for your macro to the execute the following actions section. You can leave the otherwise execute the following actions section empty. And then we need to add one final action to the end of the macro outside of the if action. You need the set variable to calculation action. Again, make sure this is at the end of your macro and outside of the if section. Copy and paste your variable name from the top down here to the variable field. And then copy and paste DAY open parentheses, close parentheses, in all caps, with no spaces, to the to field down here at the bottom as well. Make sure to avoid spaces at the beginning or end of the variable and calculation fields. And this is the logic that makes your macro run once a day. The last action is kind of like checking something off of your daily to-do list. The if statement up top is looking to see if this box has been checked already. You can run this macro to see if it works, and it should only work once. If so, you should be good to go. If not, make sure you double-check your variables for any extra spaces, and make sure your day, open parentheses, close parentheses, is correct. And that you change the variable condition up here from contains to if, exclamation point equal sign. Hopefully, tomorrow morning, you'll get to see the magic of automation firsthand. If you need to rewatch any part of this video, you can find timestamps in the video description below. Down there, you'll also find a link to a blog post on my site with resources and links to help you further, including a link to download my morning coffee macro and a link to the original forum post which showed me the directions. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, please consider liking, sharing, or subscribing. There will always be more content like this coming.